Now it is time for a sort of rapid fire. It's what we call a getting to know you. It's a getting to know you rapid fire. It's not a wildly tricky one. But so I suppose we'll just start off by asking very simply, what would honestly be worse, being stuck in that apartment or on a desert island?
I think a desert island for
right?
sure.
Yeah.
I think apartment, because island you can probably still eat fish and right. get some food arranged. But apartment, yeah. yeah.
I'm promoting trap.
My dog yeah. used to eat the sides of the walls.
It depends on the size of desert island. I mean, if you're like, if it's one little bar of sand with one tree, I think not so much.
It's I'm a big Castaway right. fan, but right now we're promoting trap.
Okay, yeah. fair enough. Okay, so when you're sitting back and watching, comedy, thriller, romance, which floats your boat?
Comedy or thriller?
Yeah.
Comedy and romance.
Star Wars, The Avengers, or The Gotham Gang?
I think when you take into account overall, I'd say just Star Wars.
Star Wars?
Gotham, yeah.
All right. What is your go-to movie meal? Popcorn, nachos, candy, or edamame? Or coffee and carrot?
It depends, actually. It really depends what kind of film I'm watching. Yeah. If I'm watching a really serious drama, I hate people like yeah. sitting next to me and like, ah, guys, no.
Right, okay. Fair enough.
Candy. Sure.
What matters more eventually, box office bonanza or an award at, you know, say an international extremely important festival, Cannes, Berlin?
I think personally for me, it's the award,
right.
but I know career-wise, commercially, it's box office.
I think it's somewhere in between where
yeah. Yeah.
the most important thing is your film shouldn't lose money. So right. Anything after that is all... Yeah. Well, because it's all a bonus.
I haven't produced any of the films yet, so I don't know.
Yeah. An Oscar or a national award, which matters more?
कल तो पता नहीं कब मिलेगा सर नेशनल का चांस है नेशनल बोल देते हैं
नेशनल तो मिल गया अपने को ना यू हैव सो डू आई थिंक सो
आई एम अवार्ड्स
सिंस वी ऑलरेडी हैव द नेशनल अवार्ड्स आई वांट टू से
जस्ट पुट इट आउट देयर
इन केस द ऑस्कर जूरी इज वाचिंग ऑस्कर्स एंड नेशनल जूरी वाचिंग नेशनल अवार्ड
एंड लेट्स जस्ट होप दे मेक द राइट अनाउंसमेंट योर फेवरेट मूवी ऑफ ऑल टाइम्स
Oh, my favorite movie is probably Amara Kumar Anthony.
Yeah?
Godfather 1.
Your favorite TV show of all times?
Oh, God. Yeah. There's too many, man. There's The Wire, there's Breaking Bad, there's Better Call Saul, there's a bunch of them. There's too many.
But like of all times, like including even childhood or, you know, early teens.
Oh, like that?
Yeah. Anything.
Mash?
You?
Right now, Breaking Bad, but I think if I go back, I loved watching Dekh Bhai Dekh when I was growing up.
Yeah. And Seinfeld? What's your favorite book?
Yeah, I'm just trying to like think which ones. I mean, there's been a lot that kind of like, you know, whether it's the I'm going to go with Harry Potter actually, because I don't think I've had more fun reading a series of books than the Harry Potter books. Really.
Entirely with you.
Yeah. You?
Yeah. Favorite director? No, seriously, it doesn't even have to be
one thing.
No, but I'm saying you can even look overseas. You can talk
Okay, let's not talk about India.
But yeah.
Let's not talk about Indian directors, okay?
Okay.
But I know him. But he knows.
Yeah.
I think he's one of the best we have.
Okay.
Yeah. He's a genius. Yeah. I'm not just saying it, I mean it, guys, really. I spent so much time with him and I know him so much better now.
I'm also taller than him.
No.
But do you have one?
Oh,
you can start. Let me think.
With me, internationally, I mean, there's so many of them. I mean, Kurosawa, Hitchcock, Billy Wilder, for me, the three masters that have pretty much taught everyone
everything.
Yeah. And I think in the modern day, I think there's a David Fincher I love, Christopher Nolan I love, Steven Spielberg, Danny Boyle. So many cool directors, so many cool. And here, I think Kashyap, definitely, I love him. Dibakar, Raju, and then going back into the past, definitely Gurudat, Ray, Bimal Roy, and Vijayanand. My favorites.
From India, I would say Rishikesh Mukherjee.
Yeah.
And Rishikesh.
And international, I think David Fincher for sure, and Steven Spielberg,
Favorite actress? Again?
Meryl Streep.
Okay.
Yeah.
And closer home?
I love so many of them. I don't know if it's fair to name one, but...
Okay, favorite co-star?
Co-star? I worked with Kangana, Vidya.
Commit, come on.
Same.
They were
give
both fantastic.
Give no,
one.
No, no, they're both extremely talented.
Really can't.
Padulekha. My favorite is Padulekha. Yes, sorry. Padulekha is my favorite actress.
Thank you, sir.
right, well done.
I don't think I've seen a more wonderful actress than Nutan actually on screen. I think she's so phenomenal. Yeah.
Favorite actor?
Mr. Bachchan. I still think there's so much potential in him to kind of like go out there and deliver something, you know, and you kind of like want to like just feel that people should really sort of tap into something other than the kind of like the persona stuff. I think there's so much there.
Well, from West, it will be Daniel Day-Lewis and Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yes.
And from India, I think it's Mr. Bachchan here.
Mr. Bachchan. If you had to make a choice, so Divakar or Vikramaditya? No, you're next.
Oh, hey, you're next.
Why don't you ask him first?
See, they both are very different filmmakers. Trust me. But somewhere, you know, somewhere actually, not exactly, but somewhere the approach towards their actors is kind of same.
Okay.
So I think I would have both of them. Why can't we have one? Vikram Banerjee, yeah.
It's the lucky man who can say so for you.
He's half Bengali, so yeah, he can be Banerjee.
Okay.
That's true.
Think so for you, Ranveer or Rajkumar?
Both of them playing brothers.
See, now, it's Ranveer Rao.
It's with Baji Rao, so yeah, you can play Ranveer Rao, yeah.
Okay. The thing you hate most in the industry and the thing you like most about.
It's the having to put up a facade sometimes in the industry. There's a certain amount of hypocrisy in having to constantly kind of like keep up with a certain facade, which I don't like. I think there's a little, I wish there was more of a, you can be who you want to be without having to kind of like kiss everyone's ass.
It's presumptuous, but I would postulate that you perhaps are not great with, or you don't actually find yourself facading often, for lack of a better word.
No, I don't, I can't facade. Right. I really can't. And it makes people kind of like saying, oh, what an arrogant. It's fine. I'm people who know me know I'm not, but it's just like it is
what it is.
What's the worst thing about the industry? What is the worst thing? I'm so happy being here. I don't know. honestly, I don't know. Okay, really, what's the worst thing? I think probably sometimes you have to be. Though I'm still being, but sometimes you have to be politically correct because as you said, you try to be real, you tend to be, you want to be real, but sometimes you can't. You can't tell them the truth. They listen, it's a horrible film. Yeah. You can't tell them.
Yeah.
This is
understandable.
Especially in trials. Like, yeah. 2 days before the film, how is it? It's like,
congratulations!
Amazing.
Yeah, it's amazing. Cinematography is great.
good story. Yeah, very good. Yeah.
So we're going to end quickly.
But the best thing.
The best thing.
The best thing is, I think personally, and I think that of all the industries, I love the fact that it's such a democratic industry in a certain sort of way that, you know, if you are talented, and I truly believe this, audition well, you'll eventually get the role. You know what I mean? There is a whole sense of, I don't know. There's very few stories I know of like super talented people who never got a break. Just like, but it's also with ADs as well, and with directors.
So there's a lot of conversation now because of what Kangana said about the sort of nepotistic nature that can exist. Do you believe there is, even if that exists, there is side by side serious meritocracy?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
I think for every I'm kind of to sort of take names in the negative sort of like way, but. There is, because at the end of the day, it's the public who's deciding whether you're worth it or you're not worth it. You know, so there's been enough. Yes, there's been nepotism where, because somebody's son, they've got a chance to go out there and make 1, 2, 3, 4, 10 films. But after that point of time, it's like the
it's
public
your work
decides.
Speaks, yeah.
Your work speaks, and the public decides whether you need to be there or whether you can be there anymore or not. It's not really up to you or the industry to sort of like keep you on that pedestal. And at the same time, with any of all of those stories, you've got so many Manoj Bajpayees, Nawazuddin Siddiqui's, Irfan Khan's, Rajkumar Rao's. Out there every single day. Not only that, Shah Rukh Khan's, Amitabh Bachchan's, who are kind of like, who have come up from nowhere and sort of like made their mark.
Yeah.
And that's wonderful, right?
Yeah, that's amazing.
See, my I don't have any problem with the. See, if I'll have a kid and my kid would want to be actor, I would, of course, get them trained and get them properly trained and teach them the passion for cinema and acting. My problem is when somebody's not worth it, somebody's unworthy to be an actor and still, we are bombarded with their films. My problem is with that. Yeah.
I'd like to end as James Lipton does with the Bernard Pivot questionnaire from inside the actor studio. So, if I may, your favorite words or word?
There's a dialogue from my film Shahid, which I really like, which says, "Vakht lagta hai par ho jata hai."
Nice. For you?
Action.
You know, that actually works right for you. Your least favorite word.
I can't, or we can't. Yeah. That's like my least favorite word.
I'm an actor, I have to play with words. There's no least favorite word.
Yeah. Fair enough. What sound or noise do you love?
What sound or noise?
Slurping. Is that what you hate it? Sorry.
No. I like it.
Slurping.
No, actually, I'm kidding.
Okay. I love, for me, like, the sound of a like a electric guitar going. Yeah. I love that kind of stuff. But now that in the last 2 years, I have to say, I'm totally soppy, but I love the sound of my daughter talking to me.
I was about to say that. Yeah.
That is nice.
Yeah. I love listening to kids and they make their own words and sounds. So yeah.
Least favorite sound or noise?
You live in Bombay. There's so many. Honking. My God, I can't stand it.
What profession other than your own would you hate to attempt?
Stockbroker.
I can't do the same thing again and again, so probably call center. I can't be in a customer care and saying the same thing.
Do the accent for 5 seconds.
Yeah. I've tried it, trust me, I've tried working in a call center when I was in Gurgaon. Everybody was doing it, so I thought, let me.
Do the accent.
Hi sir, my name is John. I'm calling from Washington. Whatever. Same thing. 9 to 5. Yeah. No, it's
the one you would love to attempt. Another profession.
Too late in life right now, but footballer.
Really?
Huh? I would love to be an astronaut.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. That would be very fun. I know. Question is, if heaven exists, what would you like to hear God say to you at the pearly gates?
That's a tough one. Yeah. I'm not much of a believer, so this is like, for me, it's like a leap of faith to kind of like.
Yeah, no, I'm not.
Imagine. Huh? Imagine
God is saying, there's a dog for everyone.
Heaven would it not?
Yeah, exactly.
It's all worth it.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, wait, actually, all your dogs through your entire life are all here waiting for you.
Sold. I'll check into that heaven anytime. I will check in. Right? Guys, thank you so much. Such a pleasure getting to catch up with the both of you. And all the best for Trapped.
Thank you.
Yeah. And thank you once again for the chills.
March 17th.
March 17th.